And I told him, Lord, any money you will give me that will take me to hell, let it not come. And I say it before God. Some of you, this is the first deliverance this night. You will not roll on the floor, but something is leaving you. Hallelujah. Look at this. Some of you have lied to your parents because of this. Some of us are playing pranks in our workplaces. You can cut corners. Christians, born again. Let me tell you something. If you're offended, I'm sorry, but I'm going to say it. There are many corrupt and wicked Christians in the body of Christ. They are born again. They are filled with the Holy Ghost. But you go and see what they do in their workplaces. Hallelujah. You sign out for goods. It's supposed to be 7 million. You now sit down with a few people and say, let's negotiate. We will give the pastor tithe. And we have certain pastors. May God have mercy on ministers. When the man talks to the pastor, he says, of course, wisdom is profitable to direct. Are you a fool that you say 7 million? Make it 23 or 24 so that at least they will give you 17. And then you now bring it to church. See, we men of God will not say it because we are benefiting from it. If you buy me a Jeep from that money, let me tell you the truth. Can I be honest with you? Many people will go to hell because of this thing. And tonight, you must make up your mind to be prosperous. Spiritually first, the other matters. Because the Bible says there is no peace to the wicked, saith the Lord. Whether it's a wicked millionaire, there is no peace. This one, money cannot give it. He said, peace I give unto you. My peace I leave with you. Not as the world gives. May the Lord never give us money that will take us to hell. May the Lord never give us money that will make us partner with Satan. May the Lord never open us up to opportunities that will jeopardize our Christian life. Look at me. Wealth in the kingdom is not an achievement, it's a trust. In the kingdom, you don't achieve prosperity, you are trusted with it. In Matthew 25, the Bible says he gave them that talent. After a while, he came back to seek for accountability. This is the difference between kingdom wealth and just wealth. That you realize that I'm a steward by grace of this that God has given. Say after me, in the name of Jesus, I will not let money take the place of God in my life. There are some sisters right now that are not even in their houses. They are in one man's house. You came for koinonia, but you came from somebody's house. What are you looking for? Money. He can sleep with me, no problem. Because of money. You mock God every time you compromise to be rich. You mock God. You insult God and you say God is not able. But our God is Jehovah Jireh. He's more than enough. Are you listening to me? Some of us may need to end some dangerous, devilish association. There are some of us students right now. You are already planning to swindle your parents. It's in your plan. You and the group of friends, you're already planning to tell them, oh, I'm in final year. I'm in this. I need 200,000. And then you cut corner. Whether you come and stand here and drop the tithe, God will not honor what comes from a heart of wickedness. He said, because thou hast loved righteousness and hated wickedness. Therefore, God, even thy God, has anointed you with an oil of gladness above your fellows. See, many Nigerians hearing this message will be angry with me. They'll say, you are a fool. Oh boy, now for you, are you in Nigeria? See, I'm a young man, no? I'm a young man. I'm not 100 years old. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I'm a young man. Don't think I came from one planet. I grew up in this very Nigeria. You can walk in the dignity of kingdom integrity into the blessings of God. There are many men today because of the do you know that the reason why some of our uncles cannot bless us is part of the covenant that they had in covens before they got well? Have you seen people like that? They are so wealthy, they can even give the poor, but they will never help anybody in their family. It's part of the agreement. They have sold their soul to the devil for it. I've said it again and again. A man whose wife suffered with him, they drank garri together, they prayed together, they went from house to house, brought a man of God to conduct night vigil. Now God blesses the man, and the man turns and looks at his wife and says, you are not fine again. Money has opened his eyes. The tree of the knowledge of good and evil has made him to see something he's not supposed to see. Hallelujah. Many wealthy people compromising on their wives, compromising on their children. They will sit down, be crying and dying of hunger, and the man is there servicing one Jezebelic lady somewhere. Can I tell you something? Whoever did not believe in you before you became blessed is not qualified to be part of your success cabinet. Brother, if the sister cannot see what you are seeing, when you get blessed and she comes, pack your load and go. Don't come around and say, I don't believe in him. And then later you call him and say, I'm working in Shell. Say, but you've not been calling me now for you. My brother, go away. Run quick. Go and find somebody that believed in you. Are you getting blessed? Say spiritual prosperity. Your spiritual prosperity. I did something one day years ago. I put 1,000 naira, plenty on the ground. And I said, Lord, I stepped on it. I said, Lord, as I'm standing on this money, it will never stand above me. This is my vow with you, that it will never stand above me. Do not give me any level of resource. I've told God, do not bring us as a ministry to any level that will kill the fire of God in our lives. Suddenly, the sick are not healed again. The only thing we're celebrating in Koinonia is just prosperity. People are not saved. People are not blessed. People are not healed. People are not delivered. They are not taught the word. May God forbid it. We respect prosperity, but it must be holistic, starting from our spiritual life. Many men of God don't take altar calls in churches again. All that they are concerned about is money. Money, money, everything is money. Even on crusade ground, money, everything is money. Can I tell you the truth? Money is not everything. What shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world? Satan tested Jesus in this. He took him up to a cliff and showed him the glory of the kingdom in a matter of time and said, bow to me. In other words, compromise your spiritual prosperity and take financial prosperity. And he looked at him and he rejected that temptation. Many of us, this is what has happened to so many people. Many of our parents have brought a lot of tragedy to our homes because they went to go and visit a herbalist and it backfired. They won't tell anybody where they went to. But in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, nothing and no one will take the place of God in our lives. For some of you, this is your message tonight. This is a revelation that God is giving you. Because the way you are pursuing this money, you may lose your salvation for it. There are some of us who are hustling. We are in anything that works. Once you see somebody with nice watch, you just say, how did you get it? Say, there is something. That's how you keep following. How can you be so gullible that you don't care whether what it is whether it's compromising your... That's how many believers have gotten into drugs. Do you know how many believers do drug dealing, including pastors? Many men of God in this country do drugs. They do drugs. Many ladies go around, they travel to Italy. You go to Italy and go to UK and see how many Nigerian ladies are there trying to make money. They send part of the money home and their loved ones build houses and they call pastors to come and dedicate it. Never allow anything compromise on your faith. I'm speaking to you right now. There are some of you sisters, there is a brother right now that is coming around your life. He loves God. His spiritual prosperity is sound. It's just that he's on his way to balance himself financially. But because of your being gullible, you see a man, you know this guy is not born again, but you are just chasing him because of finance. And then when you come to us and we ask you, is he born again? You say, hey, he's okay. Okay, it's not spiritual salvation. Is he born again with clear fruits of the Spirit working in his life? If you truly love him, bring him for koinonia. Let him be changed. You are not the Holy Spirit. Don't carry anybody because of his money, because he just parked his Jeep in front of you. One accident can take that Jeep away, but his spiritual prosperity connects him to a source that can reproduce it again and again. Hallelujah. Brothers, I bring you a word of encouragement. Let no man despise you. You are sitting down, your shoe may be caught in under, but trust me, if your spiritual prosperity is sound, eventually all these other ones that we'll talk about will come into play. Stop that hustling. Any business you want to join, anything you want, I just want to hustle. Stop it. There is a way that seemeth right unto a man, and the end thereof are the ways of death. God can guide your life to walk circumspectly into a realm of abundance. He said, and I will give you the treasures of darkness and the hidden riches of secret places. Hallelujah. See, there is nothing that irritates me as a man who tries to pursue money and does not value God. Go around our society, you see people with 3 phones, 5 phones, making all kinds of calls. Hello, hello, I'm here, I'm going to this, I'm going to the airport. You go to the airport and see them, sycophants, all kinds of people trying to make money. They want to hustle. I must make it. Can you print book? Yes. Can you fix shoe? Yes. Can you make hair? Yes. Everything, you just want to hustle. It's not done that way. Your spiritual prosperity. There are men who stop coming to the house of God from the day they were blessed. You call them and they say, sorry, I have to be in Germany now. After that, I will touch Brazil briefly and then I'll come through Ghana. May God give you the health to keep traveling. For as long as you have needs, it's not a big deal to pursue God. Is that true? For as long as you have needs. But let the needs be satisfied. There are some of us who will leave God. Say, in the name of Jesus, I am born again and born again for life. Not money, not power, not access, not influence will take me away from the love of Christ. The apostle speaking, he said, what shall separate us? What shall separate us from the love of Christ? There are some of us, very little things have separated you this morning. Don't get me wrong, money is very important, that's why we are teaching it, but it's not the way.
Thank you for watching our entire video today. If you feel you can bless someone, please join us and spread the gospel by sharing this video on your social media.